Hey guys, I want you to hear a story. You had some amazing days. Have been good?
Yes.
You had to hear this. First, a little story. Luke chapter 10, Jesus said, the harvest is great, the workers are few. We pray the Lord of the harvest to send out workers, but then he sent us out as lamb among wolves. He said, don't take any knapsack, extra purse, anything with you, because God will provide our needs. Then he sent us out to find our personal peace. That is somebody who's ready, somebody the Holy Spirit is drawing. When we find that personal peace, led by the Holy Spirit, we enter into the house. And there we eat and drink what they serve. And we heal the sick and preach the gospel. And then we're not too fast to go from house to house, but we stay there. That is what they did in the early church. That is what Jesus said. And when Jesus said it, it's not for us to quote it or memorize it or only read it. It's for us to obey it. And we see it in Book of Acts, how they went to Cornelius and his house, the jailer and his house, and so on and so on. We have been talking about Luke chapter 10 here at the school. We call it Luke 10 School. And we have been training. And a few days ago, we did what we call the Luke 10 trip, where we took all our students and we sent them out in teams. And 2 days ago, Friday morning, they were sent out, and you can see the video with that here. What is your name?
The Chosen Ones.
Where are you going?
Hendersonville.
What do you expect to see?
Fruit.
Lots and lots of
bread, the gospel.
Yeah.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Very excited.
Yeah. Okay, let's go. Come and tell some testimony later. Yeah! But now it's Sunday, and they are back again for their trip. It was amazing.
It was amazing.
And I want you to hear, because God is speaking. Before we send you out, you had a time where you came together and prayed, and God showed you something. What was that? Among many other things.
Well, he gave me the name Hendersonville, and we have no idea where that was, so we got a map.
So you all Google it and found a place on
map? Yes, we did. We got on the phone and pulled up a map, and we looked at all the surrounding areas, and we put the map up, and we prayed, and I kept getting Hendersonville. So we headed to Hendersonville.
So they got this city. Yeah. And what more?
I saw a picture of a blue house with thick white trim on a hill, or at least I thought it was on the hill because I could only see the top part of the blue house with white trim.
And she was sharing that because when we send the students out, we had like a big board, white board, where we write the name of the team. We write where God have said they should go. It was written Hendersonville, and what God showed them. And there was written in blue house on a hill with a white trim. And what happened? You went out. And God led you to that house.
Yes, yeah.
Well, how did that happen?
That would have probably been Lyndon and Maria.
Uh-huh.
So before we left, you had asked us, like, what are we looking to see? And we all agreed fruits. And as we were walking through Henderson, we came across this couple who let us pray for them. They were the only couple that would let us pray for them. And one of the things they prayed for was their brother who had some neurological disease. So we laid hands over him in his stead and prayed over him. He said he's in Fruitland. So we asked if we could go see him. And I was like, Fruitland? Like, isn't that what we asked to see? Like, that can't be ironic. Like, so we just kept ministering to people and asked, seeing who we could lay hands on and heal, who we could pray for. But people kept turning us down. And so finally, I just kept hearing, like, dust off your feet and go to the next town. But I was like, no, I'm not going to say that because, you know, we're here. God told us to be here.
And sorry, this is also what Jesus is saying. Mm-hmm. It's very important because if you want to find that personal peace, the Holy Spirit is drawing, you had to obey Jesus' word. And he said, if they will not receive your message, take the dust off your hands and feet and move on. So you did it.
Right. So we knew we were supposed to be in Hendersonville. What we didn't know is that Fruitland is still technically in Hendersonville.
Yeah.
So we looked for the rest of the, you know, the signs that we had seen. She had a heart to go see the sheriff's office, which is another big part of this testimony. We went there. Again, we got turned down. I was like, you know what, guys? I think we just need to go to Fruitland. We just need to go.
Let's go
and
to
so,
the fruit.
Yeah, exactly. And so we drove to Fruitland, and we were looking for...
And it's an area for the city.
Yeah, yes. It's full of orchards. Orchards
they grow
everywhere.
Okay. Apples,
literal fruit everywhere in Fruitland. So we were driving, we went down one road, we didn't see anything, we kind of felt like we were getting lost, so we made a U-turn, we came to a fork in the road, and Scott
I said,
here,
which way y'all want to go?
And I said, right. It was just like the first thing that popped in my head. I was like, we need to go right. And so we went right. And I started having a lot of doubts, like, oh, why did I say that? You know, but we just kept going. And the Lord was faithful, because even though we went down that road and we still felt like we were getting lost, as we were coming back, I was like, you know what, Lord, you're still faithful. Like, we know that we're going to find this person of peace. It's not about the signs. You are still faithful. And I look up and I was like, oh, guys, look, there's a blue house. There's a blue house with white trim. There's a blue house with white trim, and it's on a hill, and it's surrounded by green. And so we had to go. So we went up there, and that was our person of peace.
And we have a picture I can show here. And I put it in here. And here you can see the house. When you saw that house, what did you think?
I was just in shock. Like, it was exactly what I saw. Exactly what I saw. The Lord showed me her house.
Yeah, and it was in details what she saw before.
Yeah.
So the Holy Spirit really leads today.
Yes,
then what happened when you came into the house? Because then you met somebody.
Yeah, we walked up to the door and we were greeted by Mickey, and we just told her the story. We said, we're on a journey. It's called Luke 10. We explained it to her, and we said, we saw your house in a vision and God sent us here. And she began to cry, because earlier that day she got word that she was gonna have to put her dog down that she had for a long time, and that her brother had cancer and she needed prayer. And so we prayed for her. And then after that, she actually told us, she said, what's amazing is I was in a really dark time in 1984, and God sent four people to her door, three women and one man. And they ministered that she needed a personal relationship with Jesus, and they planted a seed. And then 36 years later, we're on her door in a dark time for her there to pray.
Three women and one man. Wow.
36 years later, the Lord wanted
God
to complete
is faithful.
That
will. Yeah.
Listen here, Jesus said the harvest is great. There is people out there who are like a person of peace. Like Paul, or before he became Paul, Saul, he was a person of peace. He was blind at home, sitting, seeking God. God spoke to a guy called Ananias, and God spoke to Ananias and told him exactly where to go. Go to this street called Straight, go to that house, this neighbor Simon, knock the door, there's a guy there who are seeking God, who are ready. And Ananias came, and we got Paul. And here you are so much led out of the Holy Spirit, and 36 years before a seed was planted, and now you came. And it was a woman, how old was she?
She's 81 years old.
And what ended up happening? You stayed there?
We stayed there the whole weekend ministering to her and her husband and their brother, and just loving on them and being patient with them and eating the food that they gave us, delicious food.
So good.
And sleeping in the beds they offered us. And then,
today we got to baptize her. Woo-hoo! At 81 years old. She found a spot in the creek.
She couldn't in the get
river.
In the water
Have you seen the video?
Enough. Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Here's the video. You see now the video where you're down in the water, and she was not afraid. It was cold.
No, she was not. It wasn't bothering her one bit. She wanted what Jesus had.
She was
had.
Desperate for Jesus. So hungry for the Lord.
So
all these years she thought she was saved, but as we shared the gospel with her, she realized that she was not born
was
again as she thought.
Yeah. Yeah. And she was in the telephone with everyone.
Oh, yes.
How was that?
Like 10 people a day, like 5 people a day. Actually.
It was ridiculous.
And telling everyone about what was happening, and you're going back again there.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And you did what the Bible says. You stayed in her house. Yeah. Stayed in the house of person of peace. Mm-hmm. They provided the food for you, took care of you. You are not fast to move on. You have time to disciple her and train her and be with her. And when you finally left for now, there was crying like it was family.
Yeah. Yes.
First for you, how was it to experience this life?
It was amazing, because the biggest thing that I learned was when, you know, we read the word and it's amazing, but when we actually read it and do what it says, it does what it says it's going to do. Like Jesus said, do these things and this will happen. And that's what I got to see in real time, that we watched the Bible unfold and open.
You came one time here to our Jesus Center to help with practical work, or how was it? And you ended up changing everything, and now you're back here on the school. How is this life compared to what you saw before?
Well, it's very real, because we're ready to give everything and follow Jesus. Like we already have a small tiny house on the trailer, and we're trying to go smaller so that we could do this full time and just follow him, you know, as he leads, because we realize in this Luke 10 trip that this is real, without a shadow of a doubt. And it's what we were made to do.
And it is for everyone. I really want to encourage you out there. also with taking the first step of going out and be bold in praying for people and sharing Jesus, because she's actually fruit of that, because on another kickstart, another place, she was working on Cracker Barrel. When was that?
That was 3 years ago.
And what happened on Cracker Barrel?
At the time I was homeless and doing drugs and hopeless, and people came in and three ladies asked me if they can pray for my leg, and when they did, I felt the Holy Spirit. And after that, I needed more. I texted them. I said, I want to get baptized after I looked into the gospel. And God changed my life completely 3 years after.
And her twin sister are born again, love Jesus now. God have done so much. Is this real?
Oh, it's real. And not only my twin sister, but her husband and four of my friends who I used to party with. So it's real.
It's real. And for you out there who are maybe longing for this life, God hears your prayer, because... What happened with you short time ago?
Yeah, so short time ago, this past Christmas, I gave my life back to the Lord. I grew up in the church. I believed once saved, always saved. And I found myself in a place where I knew I didn't have the Holy Spirit because there was no fruit of it in my life. I found myself on Christmas trying to get as high as possible, trying to get as drunk as possible, and nothing would suffice. Like, nothing made me feel better until the Lord met me in that moment. And I cried out to him and I said, Lord, I repent. Forgive me for this life that I've been living. I don't know if you can fix this, but if you can, if I have one day left, make something of my life. I need to be discipled. I need a community of believers that understand the word the way you want the scriptures understood, and I need them to help me get back to that faith. And he did. I feel like a few months later, I fell into this great house church, and the Lord really shook my foundation and let me know the things that I believed that were solid and the things I believed that were misguided. And one of the things I had prayed for that night was also discipleship specifically. Like, Lord, I don't know how to do this, but I know there's more to life than just church on Sundays. And here I am at this Luke 10 school with a group of people I met 2 months ago, and the Lord is just showing himself faithful every day.
Beautiful. What would you say to people? You get one word each to people out there who was maybe where you were before. This is for you out there. Listen here. What would you say to people?
Go out. Yeah, believe in Jesus, because he will save you.
He's faithful and he hears your prayers.
Mm-hmm. Obey the word. Do what he's telling you to do and he'll back it up.
I sat in church for a long time, but when I decided to give that life up and start really walking with him, he showed up. He showed up.
And I want to say that what happened with them today, we do this on every school where we take our students and we train them, teach them and disciple them, and then we send them out. Every time we do that, there's testimonies. Why? Because Jesus promised. Like, he has said it, go and see, I am with you. But you will not see he's with you if you don't take that step and go. And it's so simple. And this is the call of Jesus. I've written a book called The Call of Jesus. And that book is life-changing. It's not big. New revelation. It's just Jesus' words. In The Call of Jesus book, I go to Jesus' teaching. Word by word, what is Jesus saying in Luke chapter 10? How did the early disciples obey? How do we see it in Book of Acts? And how do we obey today? I recommend the book if you want to live this life. If you don't, you can get it on Amazon, on the website. If you don't have the money, send an email to mail@thelastreformation.com. mail@thelastreformation.com. Say you like to read the book and we can send it for free as an ebook. Read the book, read the word, and start to obey it. Beautiful. This is alive.
Live it.
Amen.